Title, Low Stress, Bike Accessibility. Can you get there by bike if you're a person, like most people are, who doesn't want to ride where there's high traffic stress? I think I don't need to tell this group too much that mass cycling is something that society should invest in. It's something that we need because it addresses so many of the significant challenges that our society faces. And the good news for all of us, and especially for those of you who are in government, is that people are ready to do this. If you build it, they will come. Cities, one after another, have shown that this is true. But one main thing stands in the way, and of course, it's not bad pavement. It's not bad weather. We have clothing for that. It's high traffic stress. Now, that gets you to think about infrastructure, and infrastructure can be a mixed bag. There's a nuance to it. We all know and love separate bike paths. They're low stress for sure because they protect you, they separate you from traffic. Bike lanes, well, you know, bike lanes can be nice and low stress, but bike lanes can also be very high stress, like the bike lane here where one of my students studied it. 45% of the time, a bike could not continue through because the bike lane was blocked by a double parked car or a door or something like that. And riding in mixed traffic, well, it can be very low stress if it's a quiet street, but high stress otherwise. So we have done some historical comparisons from the past to the present, and then later from the present to the future. This was the bike infrastructure in Boston in 2006. For this early part, the geography that we're using is Boston, not including East Boston, because the main connectivity issue there is the harbor, which is a tough one, and Brookline, because you just can't get from here to there in Boston without going through Brookline for some of your trips. So there is not much bike infrastructure. You see some nice paths that we see, and a few bike lanes and shoulders. Well, no, just only shoulders, really. And then we get to 2018, and you see there's a lot more. So if I take you back and forth, you can see, yeah, there's a lot more that's added. But what was added? What's the quality of what's added? So if it's blue, it's a bike lane that we classify as low stress, and we have a method for classifying. And if it's brown, it's a bike lane that's still high stress. And most people are not willing to ride in that. And then on top of that, look at how they're broken into pieces. A piece here, a piece there, a piece there. It's almost like if you drop some toothpicks on a coffee table. So the question is, can you get from here to there? So we do a lot of this kind of a study, connectivity study. Thedge is a genius with GIS. So here's the distribution of jobs in the Boston area. You can see high concentration downtown, Longwood Medical, Back Bay, Cambridge, and so on. And so when we do the analysis, we asked, in 2006, be about the same as 2000, before Boston's mayor began to say, let's do stuff for bikes, can you get from here to there on a low-stress route? And if it's red, that means it's 0 to 1% of jobs you could get to. Basically, no. And if it's green, that means it's good. Well, there is nothing green. And when we asked the same question for 2018, it's improved. But still, if you said, the simple answer is no, you wouldn't be far off. Still, for the most part, we can't say to people, hey, bicycling to work is a good option for you because we've got a low stress route. No, most people don't have that. So in our later geography, we added, in our most recent study, we've added now data from East Boston, Cambridge, and Somerville. And so here you have the infrastructure 2018. And now I'm going to compare it with the future infrastructure. This is the bike infrastructure that we gotta have. Okay, so this is Bikeways for Everybody, a campaign by the Boston Cyclist Union. We're taking input from different people in different communities. Where do you ride? Where do you need to get to? Basically, we wanna connect every neighborhood to where the activities are jobs, schools, and so on. So here's the accessibility again for 2018, now with a bigger geography. Overall average, 1.35%. That's on the average person can reach that 1% of the jobs are accessible in a low-stress route. And what would it be with bikeways for everybody? Woo! Okay, this is, and it's only 66%. There's still a few red areas. They just need a few little tweaks. We'll get that up to 70, 75, 80% with just a few little tweaks. And here's something new that we hadn't done before. We've now analyzed, what about accessibility to supermarkets? So we rated accessibility to be either good, medium, or bad. Good means you've got one that's close. That means you can either walk there in a quarter mile or you got a low-stress bike route for a mile. And if you have choice, you got two supermarkets that you can reach within a mile and a half. Medium, you got, well, either one close or two that aren't too far away. And poor means you don't have a close one and you don't have choice. And here you can see the difference. The 2018 where we are now, you got a supermarket. Here's a supermarket. And basically, the people living within a quarter mile, well, they're close to one supermarket. That's medium. And only a few neighborhoods here in Hyde Park, Brookline, Cambridge, have that good accessibility to a supermarket. Whereas with Bikeways for Everybody, we see a lot of it's lit up. And again, we'll make some tweaks and get that even more green. You've heard a lot of talk, I'm sure, about food deserts and difficulty in getting to supermarkets. One issue is, are there supermarkets? But another issue is, do you have safe bike routes to get there? I lived in a country where everybody was shopping by bike. It's great, and it's something that we could have here in Boston, too. That's it. So...